eight guys that are in that King of the Hill don't do this, but everybody else who isn't in the King of the Hill, could you grab, come up front, they're going to have buckets for you, maybe bring your helmet. I think they have buckets for you, though. You don't have to bring your helmet. And we're going to raise some money for Brian during intermission right then while we're getting ready for that King of the Hill match race. So if you're not in the King of the Hill, if you would, come on up and we'll try to raise a little money for him. And the 17W, his car is here tonight, Brian's car is here. And we're going to have it pace the field for the feature event. So that'll be while we pace truck, we'll have Brian's car pacing the field too. So anyway, be careful pulling this pits. It's a little dark over there, and just watch out. Again, I appreciate y'all coming. It means a lot to us, and I hope you have a fun time tonight.
This is Kevin Swindell, and I welcome you guys to Oskaloosa, Iowa for the Front Row Challenge.
Well, race fans, welcome to Oskaloosa, Iowa here tonight. We're just about ready for the Front Row Challenge. We've got the first pair here. We've got James McFadden on the inside, and we've got Darren Pittman on the outside. All probably familiar with this. It's a two-lap shootout. And they have to come off the line right together. Here we go. King of the Hill races starting right now. McFadden, Pittman. Looks pretty even so far. Now Pittman's going to take a lead down the back straightaway. McFadden looking on down there, but he's already... Wow, at least 6 to 8 car lengths down that back straightaway. Now 10, 12. Pittman going to pull it out, it looks like, and he will advance. Darren Pittman will move on. McFadden will start in that 8th spot. Second pair, we got Danny Lazowski on the inside, Rico Abreu on the outside. This is kind of the old guard versus the newcomers here with Danny Lazowski. He's been in the sport for a long time. Boy, Lazowski gets a heck of a jump. Off that bottom side, going to lead down the back straightaway into 3. Lazowski still with a very strong lead now. Opening up again, just about like Pittman did, probably a 10 car length lead as they go through 3 and 4. And Lazowski's gonna win this. Lazowski will win this one real easy. So, all right, we got Kerry Matson on the inside, Brian Brown on the outside. Man, they are going so slow. I'm surprised they can hardly keep the cars running. They have to start at the green cone, which is right about there. Pretty even start, but it looks like Brian Brown is going to get the jump on Mattson. And there again, it seems like the guy that gets the jump opens up a good lead. Ryan Brown with a half a straightaway lead down that back straightaway. Looks like Brown will move on, and that'll put Kerry Mattson in the sixth starting spot. Well, we've got Ian Mattson and David Gravel on this one. Looks like Mattson on the inside. See who gets the jump on this, because so far, whoever has gotten the jump seems to run away with it. Almost to the green cone. Gravel jumps out to the lead. Is he going to be like everybody else? And pull away, got one more lap. A little closer, but still Gravel with the lead. No way. Gravel with the win, Ian Mattson second. So that will put Mattson into fifth, I believe. Well, there's nothing like keeping it in the family. We got Uncle Danny here. Danny Lazowski against Brian Brown. This should be really good. We'll see how it plays out. Like Brian Brown will get the jump. Lazowski's got some good speed going up around the top there as Brown ducked down low. Brian Brown here. Still with the lead and the white flag. And Lazowski just backs out of it. And he's just going to let Danny have it. Brian Brown moves on. I think that'll put Danny into the fourth starting spot. Okay. David Gravel and Darren Pittman. Loser here will go to third place. Gravel on the inside, Pittman on the outside. Well, this looks close. Pittman's going to pull up beside him. This is one we've been waiting for. Gravel's kind of pulling up, but he's not getting that close. He's still four car lengths behind. Darren Pittman. Pittman is the winner, and Gravel will start third place. Well, this is the front row. It's just a matter of who will be on the pole. Got Darren Pittman in the black car, the number nine on the inside. Brian Brown in the white car. It's almost like good versus bad, maybe, huh? But the winner of this starts on the pole, but the other one's going to be outside front row, which I think on this track's probably not a bad idea. Seems like that outside starting spot has been good. There they go. Pittman with the lead. Pittman with the lead out of four for the white flag. And it looks like he's going to hold on to it because it doesn't look like Brian Brown can answer this. Darren Pittman's going to get a grand for that race there. So he wins $1,000 for the pole here for the Front Row Challenge at Oskaloosa, Iowa. That's going to conclude the King of the Hill running here. I think this is a special format for sprint car racing. Almost wish we could see this at just about any sprint car race that you go to, because it is so much fun to watch with the head-to-head running. Just about ready here for the start of the Front Row Challenge. Of course, we've got Darren Pittman on the pole, Ryan Brown outside, Danny Wazowski inside the second row, Gravel outside of that second row. I think the ones we kind of need to watch in this are Pittman, Brown, and Rico Abreu. They all had similar times and have been fastest cars here tonight. Looks like Pittman is going to take the lead out of turn two. A bunch of racing going on in the pack. Back there for fourth, fifth, sixth, all the way back in there. But Pittman is in first class. Ryan Brown out inside. But Pittman, with that momentum off the top, will carry it down the back straightaway. Once again, Brown to the inside, but nothing there. Danny Wazowski in that third spot, Gravel in fourth, just about like they started. I believe that's Matson coming up on the outside and gets by. Matson has just gotten by. Danny Wazowski, I believe Wazowski is going to come out as a car. Back here on the back straightaway is going to pull off. Can't make out the number. Jason Johnson, number 41. We're going to be under yellow. Your lineup here right now is going to be Pittman in first, Brown second, Danny Lazowski third. It's Kerry Matson. Oh, I'm sorry. Gravel, then Matson. That's the top five. Laps down, 28 to go. Brown looks again to the inside of Pittman, and is he going to be able to do the slide? Yes, he will. But Pittman's going to come back inside and take it right back. And we've got a yellow flag somewhere.
Caution now, driver up against the wall over in turns 3 and 4. That looks like the 10. Rager Phillips, the driver.
Your starting lineup, we've only run 3 laps. It seems more like 12 or 15. But it's Brian Brown in the lead. Like I say, 3 laps down, 27 to go. Darren Pittman in second. Danny Wazowski in that third place. David Gravel in fourth. And then Kerry Matson and Rico Abreu. I think that's about your top five or six. The two front runners of both have 2 wins apiece here at the Front Row Challenge. Brian Brown in 13 and 14. And Pittman in 2008, I think 2012. So they got some experience here. Here we go. Brown runs that low line. Pittman around the top. Looks like Brown's going to hold on to that this time, running down there along the bottom. Now he swings it up to the top. Rico Abreu now making a move. They're trying to get up into the top five, and now he's up in the fourth place. He buzzed by Matson, but he slid up into the cushion. That allowed Mattson to get back under him and get that fourth place back. Brown now stretching it out pretty good. We got another yellow flag. There it is over there on the back straightaway. We've got a car stopped up against the fence there. And I think that's Ian Mattson. We got four laps in the books. Brian Brown is still your leader. Darren Pittman in second. Danny Lazowski third. David Gravel fourth. Rico Avery now up into that fifth position here on this restart. You have to think that possibly on that red flag stoppage that they had a while ago, it was an open red. Maybe they made some changes to that car because he wasn't going anywhere earlier. But now all of a sudden he moves up a few positions and gets into that fifth spot. So keep an eye on that fifth place car, Rico Abreu. And here they come off of four for the green flag. And we're back underway. Ryan Brown in the one. Low line again. Darren Pittman up on top. Definitely look like the class of this field as they start pulling away, opening up a good margin over third place. Danny Lazowski. Now it looks like Rico Avery is trying to get around David Gravel here. And Pittman now making a run on Brian Brown. Who's it going to be? Brown is going to hold it here coming out of turn one. And the yellow is out again here with six down. Got six down now. We're going to try it again. Still got 24 to go. Got to get a good look at Darren Pittman's car here with these white wheels. Kind of looks like a throwback to me. Looks like a bunch of super modifieds back in the day. They just took that wing off, changed the body just a little bit. But everybody else either got silver or black. The only white wheels out there. But once again, Brian Brown, your leader, Pittman, Lazowski now, Rico Avery into fourth, and Gravel in fifth, and they're coming off of four. Pittman makes that run up around the top again to the outside. And now he looks like he may run around the outside of Brown as they come off. And he will. Brown with a good charge down to the bottom. But Pittman got that speed off the top. Already they open up about a 10-car length lead over third place. And it looks like Gravel gets back around Acre up the street for that fourth spot. Now Gravel on the inside of Lazowski for that third spot, but he can't do it. A lot of dust off the track here as leaders come around. Everybody kind of starts settling into a spot here. Now Mattson comes around the outside of Avery. Gary Mattson now into that fifth spot. Here comes Brad Sweet. Brad Sweet's going to get around Avery. Avery's going to challenge back here as they go into one. He takes that back. Now here goes Mattson. Or I'm sorry. Yeah, that's Mattson to the inside of Gravel. Now he'll take over. Place. But it's Pittman. Boy, Mattson was up over the cushion there in turn two, throwing dirt almost up over the fence. Pittman comes around here as your leader. He's got a 12 and 15 car length lead now over Brian Brown. Once again now, Terry Mattson now looking at on the back of Danny Lazowski. Looks like he's going to try the inside. No, he decides not to. He's almost lapped on. He goes around the outside, pulls it down to the inside, but just doesn't have enough room, I don't think, to get by there with that lap car on the inside. Pittman here comes off of four, your leader. Brian Brown. Slightly though, pulls it back down, gets in behind of Danny Lazowski. And your leader here, Pittman, now with almost a straightaway lead over Ryan Brown. Mattson doing everything he can to get that third spot away from Lazowski. Now he falls back quite a way. Mattson again goes to that outside, man, oh man. And I think we've got a yellow flag with 16 laps down. And we've got one up against the fence down here in between 3 and 4. I can't make out the number. 10. But I don't know who it is.
The yellow for the quarter 19 of Bob Lee, bringing out the caution.
Bob Lee, 19. Okay, here we come down to French straightaway. Going to turn them loose here in just a bit. 16 down, 14 left here in this 30-lap AMA Front Row Challenge in Oskaloosa, Iowa at the Southern Iowa Speedway. Got Darren Pittman in the lead. Brian Brown second. Danny Lazowski, those kind of run that way for quite a while. Looks like we got Kerry Mattson up into fourth now. Brad Sweet fifth. David Gravel sixth. And Rico Abreu there in the seventh spot. Rico's run to the front kind of got stalled, but it looks like Darren Pittman's got this pretty well in hand so far. I don't know if Brian Brown will have anything left for him or not, because Pittman is really sailing. Flying out. Pittman up to the top side. We got a three-way race back here for that third, fourth, and fifth. Mattson kind of gives up on it. Sweet goes down low now, try to get around Mattson. Some good racing back here for third, fourth, and fifth. By golly, it looks like Sweet is going to come away with that third place. Mattson into fourth, Lazowski back to fifth, Gravel in sixth. Pittman already opening up at least a 10-car length advantage over Ryan Brown. I tell you, Mattson is flirting with that fence, something fierce down here in one and two. That car is all over the place. I don't know how you keep control of it. Pittman, Brown, Mattson, Sweet. Sweet on the inside. Mattson hits that wall again, and he's going to get that third place right now from Sweet. Sweet comes back on the bottom. Mattson's going to have a bunch of speed off the top. He looks to the inside of Brian Brown as they go into turn one. Drifts up high again. Kind of separates himself from Sweet. Starts falling back from Brown. Now Sweet comes back on the inside. But no note on that one. Mattson around the outside of Brian Brown now. No room. He has to back off and let Brown have it. Now he goes back up high again, up against that cushion. Brown about mid-track. Kerry Mattson is going to get that second flag. After all the yellow flags we've had, now you're thinking you'd almost like to see one, see whether or not Mattson might be able to do something with Pittman. But Brown is starting to fade a little bit. Pittman here with about a half a straightaway lead now over Kerry Mattson. Gotta give you an idea over here. Looks like Pittman now starts to come off of four, and Mattson now just starts to come off of four. It's gotta be a second or a second and a half lead, and it just don't look like that. Able to make it up. We've got six laps to go. Brown now starting to make a little challenge up to the back of Mattson, but he's not even close. Pittman comes off of four. He's already down the straightaway, and they're just now coming off the lead. Pittman has some lap traffic back there. He's got some pretty tight running. but he's going to go blow by him on the high side. Laps, four laps to go. Six down, four to go. Pittman now. Let's go back here to the second place, Ryan Brown. Once again, looks like he's trying to mount a charge up here on Matson. Somebody's slowing down on the back straightaway, but they picked it back up to race speed. Pittman over here now, three laps to go. He's got over a straightaway lead on Barry Matson, not showing any signs of slowing down. It's 28, two to go, next lap. And he will get the white flag. We have a couple of lap cars ahead of him. Going so fast, I can't keep up. Comes off a four. There's the white flag. That shows you first place. Now there's Matt. Darren Pittman already at the end of the back straightaway through three. Goes around the lap car, coming out of four. Darren Pittman will be your 2016 Front Row Challenge winner. There's Matson, Brown, Sweet, Lozowski, and Abreu, David Gravel. Top five or six. Took a while to get this race going, but when they finally got into the last half of it, I think we ran the last 14 laps with no yellows. Darren Pittman, your winner, $20,000.
The third time he has gone to victory lane here at the Southern Iowa Speedway, and quite possibly what might be his most emotional Front Row Challenge victory here tonight. As Pittman, the undefeated, undisputed champion here tonight. Well, ladies and gentlemen, the helmet is off. Let him hear it. Your winner, Darren Pittman. All we're missing is the meltdown here, Darren. An absolutely fantastic run. Take us through that race and getting up there, and take us through that how you had to get up there.
Yeah, I lost the lead on the restart. And man, let's hear him get it back. Brown's awfully good. I hit the bottom after that. Me and Brown's both shuffle race, man. It felt awfully good. So I knew it was there. I didn't know if I should run it there. The first few laps went off. I just went back to the top where he'd been pretty good all night. He got by me on the restart. Luckily, I hit the bottom, just slowed up enough that the top kind of came back in. So man, what an emotional day. Come out here, get a win here. I haven't been here in a couple years and came out here as a spectator. Watched Brad Sweet haul $20,000 out here last year, and that's definitely motivation for me, and I think it's a motivation for our team to come back this year and run and try to go back after it. So just thanks to Kale, Steve, Josh for having this is a voluntary race. I mean, we have the biggest race of the year coming up here in 2 days, and they don't have to come, and I thank them for coming and allowing me to come out here and race. It's a lot of fun, a track that I've had a lot of success at, and I really enjoy coming too. So thanks for Casey to allow us to come out here and race and taking a chance tearing up equipment before our biggest race too. So glad for the money they put up for us. It's a blast, and hopefully we keep coming back for years to come. Hopefully you can add $150,000 to this at the end of the week. What do you think? Well, we're going to give our best. We've been getting better there every time I go back. I still got a long way to go. I feel like as a driver at that racetrack, but my car's capable, and I just got to go out there and do my job, see how we do on our qualifying night, and just try to set ourselves up for a decent position on Saturday.
Score another one for them old Okies, ladies and gentlemen, Darren Pittman!
Hi, this is Robert Bell. I'm at Oskaloosa, Iowa for the Front Row Challenge. If you haven't been here, you need to make time to come here next year for 2017.